In every case, the experienced officer knows that evidence, of course, is essential to a prosecution. In any type of investigation, it must be properly obtained, identified, and handled, so that from the moment it is lifted at the scene until it has served its particular purpose, it may be protected from contamination.
Eyewitness memory is corruptible. There are factors that can influence the quality of law enforcement. The process of investigating the crime can actually cause evidence to change. An analogy might be if the cops got the fingerprints and then mixed them up in a file or accidentally smeared them. This can easily happen in the case of an eyewitness. There are factors which can interfere with the quality of that evidence.
In our lab experiments, the thing that stands out to you when you do one of these kinds of experiments where you stage an event for unsuspecting people and then you put together a lineup and see if they can pick them out is just how often people make errors. In our lab, people may come to a study thinking that they're going to do some kind of task on a computer. Then someone comes in and engages in some kind of unusual behavior. We then put together a lineup. Witnesses would pick someone, but the real perpetrator's not there. And so they pick an innocent person. For half of them, we would just give them some feedback, say, oh, good. You know, you identified the suspect. And for others, we wouldn't say anything. Shortly thereafter, we would ask them, at the time you made your ID, how certain were you that you picked the right person? Oh, and also, how closely were you paying attention at the time of the crime? And also, how good of a view did you have when you were witnessing that crime? And all three of those things jump up dramatically in the condition in which all you did was give them a bit of encouragement after they made their ID.